Welcome everybody, I'm Laura Hsu. I get a lot of emails from folks who have lost certain features here in the Lightroom interface, so I thought I'd do a short video going over the most common occurrences of this. Whether you've accidentally hit a shortcut and hidden something in Lightroom, or you're working with Lightroom in a lab somewhere where other people have been on the machine and hidden things, you'll learn how to get things back. First, if you find that one of your modules in Lightroom has gone missing, for example, I don't see my slideshow module here, just right-click inside any of the existing modules and then choose the one that's missing. Of course, if you don't want a module to show, you can choose that to uncheck it. So now I've got back my slideshow module. Next, you can lose individual panels in Lightroom. I should have, here in the library module, I should have a catalog panel below my navigator panel here. So I'm going to right-click on one of the other existing panel names here in the same panel strip. I'll right-click on Folders, and I can choose Catalog to make it reappear. Note that you cannot right-click and choose other panels from the Navigator panel. I've gotten this question a few times with Lightroom 5 when folks have installed it. They find that they're missing their basic panel here in the Develop module. I'm missing mine, so I'll right-click on the Tone Curve panel here, and I'll choose Basic to get that back. Next, a whole panel strip could go missing. That would happen if you accidentally click out here on the edge of the strip to collapse it. You just click back in the same edge to expand it again. And that would be the case up here at the top, in the right-hand panel strip, and down here at the bottom to show and hide your film strip. Next, you may find that your toolbar goes missing. There's a toolbar in each of the modules that has different tools on it. If it goes missing, you'll type T for toolbar. So I'll type T, which will hide it, which may be what you did by accident, and then type T again to get it back. Here in grid view in the library module, the library filter bar also can go missing. So this allows you to search for your photos when you're in grid view. The backslash key, which on US keyboards is above the enter or return key, hides this filter bar, and then the backslash key again brings the filter bar back. If you forget the shortcut, you can always go up to View, Show Filter Bar. Notice that you also have the option here to hide and then to show your toolbar down here. Back on the toolbar, if you have the toolbar but not the individual tool that you're looking for, click on the little downward triangle here and choose the one you want to work with. On a high-resolution monitor, you can display all of these tools. I'm working with a low-resolution video capture, so to show an additional one here, I'd have to select and hide one of the ones I currently have displayed. Now, sometimes in individual panels, you have the panel itself, but you're missing some of the settings. I'm going to select a photo so that I have the Quick Develop panel here. Now, I know from prior experience that the Quick Develop panel offers more than just this small set of develop controls. I can see all of those by clicking on these sideways triangles to expand these individual panel sections. So anywhere in Lightroom where you see a sideways triangle, click to expand it to see what else is offered. Then if you want to collapse it again, just click on the downward triangles to collapse them. Finally, here in grid view, I'll point out that I've got information displayed above my thumbnails here. Now there's actually two different views of grid view. One is expanded view, which shows me this information, and the other is collapsed view, where that information is hidden. To move from one to the other, I can type the shortcut J. So J collapsed it, J again brings back a little bit of information, and then J a third time brings up full expanded view with that information. Now I have a separate blog post on view options on how you can set this information. I'm going to go to loupe view by double-clicking on a photo. Now I often see people working with information displayed on their photos. I think when you're trying to evaluate your photo or develop your photo, it's a good idea to hide that information. But if it's hidden and you're wondering how to get that information back, you'll type I. So I typed I once to get this set of information. I can type I again to get a second set of information, and then I a third time will hide the information completely. What information displays can also be set in View, View Options, and again I have a separate blog post on that topic. Now in any module of Lightroom, you may find that your buttons to minimize, expand, or close the program disappear. Now, this is much more likely if you're working with Lightroom 4 or earlier. In Lightroom 4 or earlier, if you accidentally hit F for full screen, you can lose these system buttons. You can also lose your Lightroom menu bar. So in that case, you would type F for full screen once or twice more, and you would restore that information. In Lightroom 5, it's harder to make that mistake because it takes Shift F to make that happen. So that's the old full screen mode behavior. I want to jump to the develop module to show you just a couple more examples of things that go missing. And for this, I'm going to go back to this photo here. I'm going to open up my basic panel. What I see is that even though I have Lightroom 5, I don't have my Lightroom 4 and Lightroom 5 basic panel controls here, which are shadows, highlights, whites, and blacks. I still have recovery and fill light from Lightroom 3. If you have Lightroom 5 and you want to see the new controls rather than continue to work with the old controls, then here in the histogram, either to the left here, or when the histogram is expanded below, you're going to click on the lightning bolt. This will allow you to update what's called the process version, or the new version of controls and technology. So I'll click on update, and now you'll see I have highlights, shadows, whites, and blacks. Be sure to read my blog post on updating process version to understand more about the implications of doing that. Now let me point out that if you have Lightroom 4, you're not going to see a lightning bolt in the histogram. What you're going to see is an exclamation point in the bottom right of your photo, warning you that you're still using the old process version. So simply click on it to update it. Now I'm going to collapse the basic panel and come down to the tone curve to cover my last feature that goes missing. Here in the tone curve, I'm missing my sliders, my lights, darks, shadows, and highlight sliders, because I'm working with the point curve version of the tone curve. If you don't see your sliders in the tone curve and you want to get back to them, you're going to click on this little square. That moves me from the point curve version of the tone curve to slider view. So now I can slide the sliders. Frankly, I don't use the tone curve nearly as much now that I have better basic panel controls with Lightroom 4 or 5. But this little square here at the bottom of it will move you between slider view and point curve view. And I have a separate blog post article on working with the tone curve. Okay, so those are the features that I could think of that commonly go missing. If you've had other experiences with missing interface features in Lightroom, put a comment in the YouTube video or below my blog post to share your experience with others. If you've enjoyed this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel and check out my blog at laurashue.com for lots of other Lightroom tutorials and videos. Finally, sign up for newsletter updates to be the first to hear about new tutorials. I'm Laura Shue. Thanks for watching.